Hi, welcome to the lesson 3 of our Spring Boot course. In this lesson, we are going to set up our dev environment, right? Because we have to build the code, so it's really important that we have the setup ready. Okay, so I'm going to talk about the different things which are really required in order for you to start creating your first Spring Boot project, okay? So let's quickly see what we are going to cover in this lesson. So we are going to cover a little bit about the system requirements, what is the minimum system requirements in order to start working with the Spring Boot. We are also going to talk about the JDK, which is integral part. You can't do anything if you don't have the JDK in your system. We're going to talk about the Maven and the Gradle setup. These are needed to build your application if you want to you want to create a var file, jar file for your Spring Boot application. We need either Maven or Gradle. For this course, I'm going to use Maven, but there is no difference if you want to go ahead with the Gradle. We also want to talk a little bit about the ID, where you are going to, your editor. We will be talking a little bit about that one as well. All right, so let's quickly talk about the system requirements. Right now, this course is based upon the Spring Boot 2.1.0. So there are certain minimal requirements which you have to follow in order to start working with the Spring Boot 2.1.0, okay? The one of thing is you need either Java 8 or 9 in order to work with this latest version of the Spring Boot. So you should have the Java 8 or 9 installed here on the system. If you are going with the Maven, like I'm going to use a Maven throughout this course, the minimum Maven is 3.3 plus. If you are going with the Gradle, 4.4.4 plus that is the minimum required by the Spring Boot. Again, I highly encourage you to refer to the Spring documentation to make sure that if you are starting with the next release of the Spring Boot, there might be some changes happening to the system requirements. So just refer to the Spring documentation to see what is the updated system requirement list. Okay, so let's start with the JDK. That is really required in order to start working onto the Spring Boot. And I'm assuming that since you already have some familiarity with the Java, you already have a Java 8 or 9 installed on the system, right? If that is not the case, just open the Oracle site, go ahead, download Java 8 or 9, install it to your system, and then we can start going to the next step. So in order to see if the Java, what is the Java version installer machine, let's quickly see how we can do that. So once you have a Java installed in your machine and you don't know what is the version and what is the location, you just have to type java-version. And you can see that right now I have a Java 1.8. I have a 2 version in fact, but this is the default one. I have a Java 9 installed on my machine, but okay. So this is the Java version installed on my machine. Okay, so make sure that you have either, as I said, Java 8 or Java 9 installed on your machine. To check what is the Maven version installed on a machine, if you are using a Maven, just run the MVN and then the version command, right? So if you see, I have the Maven 3.5.2 on my machine. If you don't have a Maven installed, I highly recommend that you should install Maven. That is really needed in order to build and run different packaging commands for your application, right? If you want to go ahead with the Gradle, just make sure that you have the Gradle installed on your machine. All right. So the last thing is your editor, right? Where you are going to develop your application, right? So there are a number of options when it comes to the IDE. My recommendation is use the IDE where you are most comfortable. Don't go with, okay, I want to use IntelliJ or I want to use Eclipse or something like that. If you are using IntelliJ, go ahead with IntelliJ. If you're using some other editors, go ahead with other editors, right? Let's quickly check out a few things. The IntelliJ IDEA, this is one of the best editor available there. If you already using that one, this is really good. If you want to try, there are two variation of it. There is a community editions. I will highly recommend to try that out. It's really, really wonderful editor. Eclipse is a free open source editor. It's really good. If you're already using the Eclipse, my recommendation is go ahead with the Eclipse. Just use it. All right. There is already a built-in support for Spring Boot, so you don't have to worry about those things. If you want a more Spring flavor to the Eclipse, there is a variation onto the Eclipse, which is a Spring STS. They have a really some good integration when it comes to the Spring-based development. So if you just want to go ahead with the Eclipse flavor with the Spring highlighted features, use that one. There are other NetBeans. You have the other ID like a NetBeans. It's all depends upon you. As I said, if you are already using any of the ID, go ahead, continue using that one, right? If there is any of the setup missing in your system, make sure you complete that setup before moving to the next lesson, because we are going to create a Spring Boot application based upon these requirements. All right.